Zahnbinde zu, I got sign in the shoebox. I can with my mood, I'm inside that movie. Wake up. 78 Sports TV here. Salute to the mighty LDBC, Lions Den basketball community in this case. Yeah, you know, I just want to take some time out, you know, just to, you know, just want to do a little something, look here, man. All I'm saying is we can't be faded. I can't be faded. You understand me? Milwaukee Bucks on top. Like I told you. Motherfuckers, when we was 9-0 to start off the season, I said the Bucks gonna win 60 games this year and we're going to the Eastern Conference Finals. My ultimate goal is, of course, for us to win, but I'm just telling you what I told y'all. Yet, I had motherfuckers hating. Man, the Bucks look good now, but they gonna fall off. The Bucks ain't gonna keep this up. Ain't no way y'all winning those 60 games. Yeah, we got to that 60-piece nugget, though. Then we smashed through Detroit. Went on to swept them. We had time to waste with Detroit. We just got them out the way. You know what I'm saying? Right? I thought we was going to beat Boston in six. I picked us to beat Boston in six. After game one, ooh, you should have seen the haters, boy. Game one, when the Bucks lost at home to Boston, boy, the haters was out in full force. Paul Pierce, monkey ass, talking about, it's over. This series is over. People following that shit. Yeah, man. Hey, 78, your Bucks is done, man. They stopping Giannis. They gonna stop Giannis. They got good defense for Giannis. What you gonna do, 78? I wasn't even doing no videos like that. Because I knew what was gonna happen. You understand? Bucks come through, ain't look back. We came through and won four straight games. You know what I'm saying? I told you what we was gonna do to the Boston Bums. Okay? They unorganized. Yet last year, it was better than it is this year. Kyrie Irving want to be a superstar and shit. Now, I feel bad for Kyrie at times, though, because he faced with a hard dilemma. But, you know, we ain't finna dwell on that right now because it's about the Bucks. So, fuck Kyrie for this video, you know. But at the end of the day, you know, we went out there four games straight and whooped on them boys' asses. We whooped them at their house, whooped them at our house. Just no mercy. Alright? Every game, they talking about the Celtics talking about, oh yeah, we gotta play better. We're gonna play better. All this old shit. I'ma tell you when I knew. Cause see, at first, like I said, I thought we was gonna win this series in six. I thought Boston might come back and win game five. When I got confident that we was gonna win game five, was when after game four, Kyrie Irving was in a press conference and they asked him about his bad shooting. He said, oh yeah, I was like 6 for 22. I should have shot 30 shots. I'm that great of a shooter. When I heard that shit, I said, yeah, baby. Shoot that motherfucker, Kyrie. Shoot that motherfucker, Kyrie. Yak him up. You understand? Yak it. You know? Shoot that shit from everywhere on the floor, Kyrie. That motherfucker Kyrie saying, fuck what y'all talking about. I'm that great of a player. Kyrie Irving is turning into Kanye West, bro. This nigga saying, fuck. Look, and you know what? Kyrie Irving deserves criticism. And I'm going to tell you why. Even though I sympathize with his dilemma, he deserves criticism. Because it's the same shit every year people criticize Westbrook for. Okay? Westbrook could be playing great the whole fucking year. Playing great. Okay? Getting his teammates involved. Motherfucker leading the league in assists every fucking year now. Still, they say he's a selfish player. Right? So, Westbrook, in the playoffs this year, he was shooting bad. He had some bad shooting games, okay? I don't know why. He don't know why. His shot wasn't falling, but it happens like that sometimes. Right? Media criticize every fucking game. They bashing Westbrook. He's stupid, and he not a smart player. He make bad decisions, blah, blah, blah. They want Westbrook to be the poster boy for fuck-ups. This is what they want to do, right? Get Kyrie Irving some of that same smoke, man. Because Kyrie Irving just did the same thing that y'all accused Russ of doing. Y'all say Russ shoot a lot of shots that he shouldn't be shooting. When he know he ain't hitting, he should be looking for his teammates. That's what y'all say. Russ, y'all say Russ ain't no real point guard. Even though he leading the league in assists every fucking year. Y'all say he ain't no real point guard, blah, blah, blah. But then y'all, the media finna give Kyrie Irving a fucking pass today. They finna give him a pass, and they gonna keep hyping up Kyrie Irving, where he going to next year. Right? This is what I'm saying. This is why motherfuckers hate Westbrook, bro. They be hating on Russ, man. But anyway, this is, like I said, this is about the Bucks. Shout out to the Milwaukee Bucks, man. This is what we do, man. Easy breezy. You know what I'm saying? Giannis didn't even have no big game. The Bucks came out there, man, we looked horrible in the first half. We looked horrible. We couldn't hit none of our shots, but luckily for us, the Celtics couldn't hit shit either. You know what I'm saying? It was one, in the second half, bro, it was a stretch where we got like 5 offensive rebounds, like right back to back. Like, we couldn't hit a shot, but we just kept snatching the boards. I said, yo, the Celtics ain't shit. They had quit, bro. The Celtics had quit. They had quit, man. They had no more fighting. We took the fight out the Boston Bums. You understand me? We took the fight out the Boston Bums. Don't ever come back to my page talking shit about no Boston motherfucking Bums, man. Don't do it no more, bruh. Don't do it. Man, you niggas crazy, man. Y'all talking all that shit. Y'all better show up. When I do my show tonight, y'all better come through, show some love. Since y'all talking all that bullshit, y'all laughing. Hey, 78. Hey, I don't know if the Bucks, hey, they got Giannis, they D'ing up Giannis. Man, get out of here. I don't know what that is. I don't know what D'ing up Giannis is. I'm not no homosexual, you understand? Y'all, that's y'all lingo. That's y'all lingo. We smash on Boston Bums around this motherfucker. Now, next series is going to be a tough series. I got the Bucks winning this next series in 7. This is going to be hard. You know what I'm saying? We got to play these boys, probably the Toronto Raptors. I really wish it was Philly, because Philly easy work, you know what I'm saying? Because we own Philly, you know what I'm saying? Musty ass Jimmy Butler, Ben Simmons ain't shit. Biggest hype job ever, Ben Simmons, man. Like, they just, the media want Ben Simmons to be good so bad, bro. They, Ben Simmons. Man, Ben Simmons ain't been shit, bro. I don't know why the fuck everybody all been sweating this dude. Ben Simmons ain't shit, man. He ain't never been shit. But regardless, cool. I mean, I'll let y'all hype the motherfucker up just so we can thrash their asses. You know what I'm saying? Show you how we supposed to do scrub-ass dudes like Ben Simmons. And then Joel Embiid, I like Joel Embiid, but Joel Embiid soft, bro. He a big old soft nigga. You know what I'm saying? He a big soft dude, man. He always got some issues. You know, he got that big man disease, man, where motherfucker always hurt, always got something going on. You know, it's just some weird shit. So, the Philly is food to us. Now, Toronto, on the other hand, Toronto is game. You know what I'm saying? These motherfuckers come to ball every rip. I'm scared of Toronto, but, hey, it's a path we got to take. We got to go through these boys. You know what I'm saying? And I think they're going to whoop our ass a few times in this series. You know, Toronto got good defense, well-placed shots, man, good shot selection on offense. Kawhi Leonard, man, like, this dude has been on fire. Kawhi Leonard's on a mission, you know what I'm saying? So, you know, this is going to be tough. And I'm telling you right now, if you ain't no Toronto Raptors fan, do not come to my comment section talking shit, okay? Just because your Celtics got their ass whooped, just because the Pistons got their ass whooped, or your favorite team didn't even make the playoffs, don't come on my page talking shit, rooting for Toronto against my Milwaukee Bucks on some hater shit. Don't be doing it, man. You know what I'm saying? Get that shit up out of here, bro. You know? We gotta do something, man. We gotta do something, man. We gotta beat these boys, man. But I am nervous about this Toronto shit. Cause they balling out. Toronto been on, they've been on our ass this entire season. We always been right there ahead of them. That's why I say this gonna go 7 games. Because we always been just a little bit better than Toronto. We ain't never been greatly better than Toronto. We always been just a little bit better than them. So to me, that translates into 7 games. And if we make too many mistakes, we fuck around, could lose to them. You know what I'm saying? So I don't know, man. Hopefully Toronto had like a major injury, like Kawhi Leonard injured himself or something, and we can get him the fuck out of here, then we can smash these clowns. You know what I'm saying? Hopefully that's what happened. You know what I'm saying? We go on a smash on these dudes. But, and after that, when we get to the finals, hey, I ain't worried about nothing else. Everything else is food. You know what I'm saying? We play the Warriors, I ain't worried about them. You know what I'm saying? Steph Curry got problems at home and shit. You know what I'm saying? Internet tearing up Steph Curry wife right now. Woman say she lonely. She need a little attention, some TLC, and the internet tearing her up. See, man, you can't trust these bitches, man. See, man, doesn't matter how much money we have, man. They just don't, they always want more and more. You know, man? You know, like a lame nigga talk. Yeah, man, there's nothing we can do, man. Man, that bitch, man, whatever, bro. I ain't gonna say that. That's that man's wife. It is what it is. It is what it is, man. Woman just need a little TLC, that's all. And women act up. Your woman act up, my woman act up. Women act up when they just want a little TLC, man. Steph been on the road, you know what I'm saying? Preparing for game, playoff mode. He ain't giving her attention. That's all it is, bro. I don't know why everybody taking this shit so seriously. You know, man, see, man, see? Like, bro, just be quiet, dude. But anyway, yeah, man, we can't be faded out here in Milwaukee. That's all I'm saying. You know what I mean? I didn't want this video to be too long. I just want to come out here and let y'all know, you know what I mean, that, you know, it's a new era. You know, everybody needs to bow down and respect it, you know what I'm saying? You know, whenever you hear the name Milwaukee Bucks, I want everybody to close their eyes, bow down and respect it, you understand? That's what you do. Wherever you are in this world, listening to this video, close your eyes, bow down and respect it. Because this is what we do. It's what we do. It's easy. It's easy to us. You understand? I told you motherfuckers, man. Talking about some Boston bums. Man, they got Giannis. They D'ing up Giannis. Man, they finna stop y'all, man. Y'all ain't finna be able to do it, man. The fuck out of here, man. Look at Bob. We sent the asses back home. Man, I knew that plane ride back home was vicious for the Celtics, man. Motherfucker lost 4 games straight. They listened to the hype after game 1, thought they had us. Them motherfuckers had to fly back home on that plane. Boy, it sucks, boy. It sucks. Mm-mm-mm. It sucks. It's a damn shame. You know? But that's what it do, you know? So I'll do some more videos, you know, as this next series, you know what I'm saying? We go up against the Raptors most likely because I think the Raptors got 1 game to close out Philly. And, you know, I think they're going to close Philly out because Philly always got some fucking excuses, man. They always got some weird shit going on, man. You know, it's weird, man, you know. So, Joel Embiid, you know, he's good at stretches. And that's why I be telling y'all about these big men in the league, man. Anthony Davis, Joel Embiid. I don't know why anybody even sweat these big men, bro. People love to talk about these athletes today being better than the athletes from the past, bro. Shaq was bigger than all these niggas. And Shaq wasn't having all these problems, bro. Shaq wasn't having all these injury problems like that, man, when he was their age. These dudes are young, and they always got some injury problems. Every time they jump up in the air, their ankle hurt. Or, like, man, get out of here. Y'all got all this technology, and for what, man? Y'all eating better foods and better diets and stuff for what? And you still walking around here all injured and shit all the time. Man, these dudes are fuck up out of here, man. They soft. That's all it is. Soft, you know, but at the end of the day, the Milwaukee Bucks will come out of the East as the champions. You understand? That's what we're going to do. We're going to come out of the East as the motherfucking champions. That's what I expect from us. You know? So anyway, I'll get with y'all in a minute. 78 Sports TV. Salute to the mighty LDBC. And I'll holler.